America and land the great odds.
Talon to the front. Talon is now the leader as they race into the final furlong of the mile. Talon and Julia Le Perroux have dominated the Breeders' Cup mile.
She is the queen of the turf. She had a successful visit with the Queen of England, and now joining us here on the TVG set at Woodbine, Nick Smith, director of racing at Ascot Racecourse. First of all, welcome. Good to have you here, Nick.
Thank you, Scott. It's great to be here. It's fantastic.
When you think back to that first race, the first day of the meeting, what do you immediately think about?
Well, it was intense, wasn't it? I mean, the whole build-up had been, will she, won't she come? A little doubt here and there. She was training great. They put her on the plane. She settled brilliantly once she got to the UK. But it was certainly a unique experience to see an American horse outstay a field of European stayers like that, just to sort of grind in. It was a beautiful ride, beautifully timed ride. And, you know, as you can see on the screen, really, it was pretty much hands and heels, and she outclassed them, really.
I kind of was turned into a peacock after that, because I was proud. I felt like, you know,
you were,
I had done something.
You were
something.
One for one.
Yeah,
you were
exactly.
One for one on Channel 4.
First trip at Royal Ascot. And the thing was, is she was 6-1 in the UK market. She was 3-1 here in the States. So needless to say, I made a few pounds on her on that day. But with this performance and this win, what does this do for Royal Ascot specifically and international racing in the UK in trying to bring over more American horses?
I think, you know, without any exaggeration, it's possibly the most important international result we've ever had. So if you look back at Black Caviar for Australia, that was wonderful, of course. It was a massive global news story. But she was doing pretty much what she'd always done. You know, 6 furlongs on a straight, she's no stranger to that in Australia. For Teppin to come over and run on a straight track, no Lasix, no nasal strip, and all the other complications, and you know, just basically having flown in, all new experiences for her, was a remarkable achievement. And I just hope it sort of sets the tone a little bit for people over here not necessarily thinking, oh, it's got to be a 2-year-old, it's got to be something nippy, it's got to be something that's
trained by Wesley Ward.
Something trained by Wesley Ward. But I mean, don't forget Graham Motion. He's had a lot of success with Miss Temple City over there. That's run twice very well at Royal Ascot without winning. But this hopefully will encourage more people to look beyond the opportunities at home, because I think as Mark Hassie and the team and Batmaster have said, it was a lot of fun. You know, it's something that they were looking forward to doing. They totally embraced it. They were fantastic when they got over there with the media. You know, it was great for our audience. We're so used to sending horses to the Breeders' Cup,
right.
And obviously we've got horses running here today. For us, it's, you know, yeah, we got on a plane to America, big deal, we do it all the time. But the other way around, it's not so usual. And that's why for them to put their stamp down like that was remarkable.
Just quickly before we wrap this up, Bilardo couldn't get to Teppan. Do you see Mutakaev or any of these other European horses getting to her today?
I think Mutakaev is a really good horse. His form with Postponed in the Jumbo International in third, with an unlucky third, is right at the top of European form. Mutakaev wouldn't have even been considered for the Queen Anne. He wasn't even on the radar. He came out of nowhere to win the Summer Mile. His third in the Jumbo International was top-class form. I mean, you would expect Teppan to win, of course you would, but she's going to have to be at the top of her game, because he's a very good horse. And whatever happens here, whether it's the Queen Elizabeth II Stakes or the Champion Stakes at Ascot, he's a horse that we're going to see winning Group 1 races soon.
Well, Nick, we appreciate it. We look forward to hopefully doing this again. Not sitting here, but another American horse going over there and beating up on you guys.
That would make me very happy indeed.
Nick Smith, Director of Racing at Ascot, as we go back to New Jersey to Tom Cassidy.
Scott, thank you very much. Race number 7 coming up here in about a minute. Horses are circling around at the top of the stretch. They don't have that long walk to the starting gate once they cross onto the turf course, because this race here is only a mile. So it'll be a short walk to the starting gate once they cross onto the turf course here. And we have a big field signed on here, a full field, a 5-2 favorite at the moment. Now, it's a maiden $35,000 claiming group. 1 mile of distance, fillies and mares 3 and up. Going 1 mile over the firm turf course, the rail at 0 feet. And our 5-2 favorite here is the 5, and that is Quick Thinker. Going out for Jane Sibelli. Now, this horse was actually cross-entered in a maiden special weight event at Parks this afternoon, but is running here for the $35,000 tag. Now, in the debut, did not show much after being ranked early on in that race, and then that was going 1 mile and 1/16, would end up finishing 9th in that field. Away a step slow that day, got over to the rail, was headstrong early on, steadied briefly going into the backstretch, sat off the pace along the rail, and flattened out in the lane. Shortened up around one turn last time out, was away a step slow again, chased the pace, looked green in the stretch, and lost a photo for fourth, finished a half length in front of the last.